So this, believe it or not, is Silicon Valley. That's Facebook's headquarters there, like 1,500 feet away. But a lot of the valley looks like this. Marshland and empty wasteland. But there's actually this big, messy story happening right here in the middle of nowhere. It's this story about humans messing up nature, then trying to fix it, then maybe making things worse, then trying to fix that. And in the middle is a big fight about what nature even is.
And to see this all firsthand, we're here at 5:45 a.m. in the middle of a marsh, listening for what everyone agrees is a really ugly bird call.
It's very kind of mechanical and rattly.
Our guides are Jen McBroom and Toby Romer. They work for a group called the Invasive Spartina Project. We'll get to that in a minute. And the bird we're listening for is called the California Ridgeways Rail.
It's a smaller than a chicken, bigger than a robin, but a little bit heavier and a heavy orange bill.
The Ridgeways Rail is endangered. There are maybe 1,000 or 2,000 left, and they're all here in the tidal marshes around San Francisco. Those very few birds are the focus of one big conservation effort, and they're completely screwing up another.
Let's try and go up there a little bit. Often there's a pair kind of
the associated. Big conflict here is that Toby and Jen are trying to save the rails, but they're also trying to wipe out the grass where lots of them live. The grass is called Spartina, and it was a product of good intentions. The southern reach of the San Francisco Bay is wide but shallow, and it's supposed to look like this. Grassy tidal marshes that give way to miles of mudflats. It's a utopia for little birds like the rail. But over the 20th century, developers began turning the marshes into what's now Silicon Valley. That meant farmland, housing, businesses, airports, and notably massive salt ponds that harvest salt by evaporating acres and acres of bay water. The marsh habitat dwindled, pushing the Ridgeways Rail onto the endangered species list. So fast forward to the 70s, when the Army Corps of Engineers is hard at work returning some of this developed land to nature. But, and this is the big mistake, they used an imported grass from the East Coast.
Generally over about the next decade, that species hybridized with our native species and begat what is now the invasive. It grows bigger, faster, taller than both of the parent species.
The hybrid grass took over the bay, crowding out native grass and even eating up mudflats where the native grass doesn't even grow. That threatened countless migrating shorebirds who rely on the mudflats, and it began to turn the marshes into a monoculture, one big sea of invasive grass. Which is terrible news, unless you're a California Ridgeways Rail.
Hybrid Spartina provided brand new novel habitat by converting mudflat that was previously inaccessible to them into marsh. So it created marsh that they could use. And it also grows so much taller than the native that it's really good cover for them from predators.
Also, we did finally see one. Toby and Jen's organization, the Invasive Spartina Project, is funded by state and federal conservation agencies. And since 2005, they've managed to knock out about 95% of the invasive Spartina, poisoning it acre by acre with an herbicide and planting native grass in its place. But that last 5% is filled with endangered rails, and they can't completely wipe out the Spartina without also wiping out the rails there.
So getting to 100% eradication is kind of daunting. I think it is feasible, though.
So they're at a standstill. Toby and Jen want to wind back the clock to before the invasive Spartina ever existed, but right now they can't. Also, not everyone is convinced they should.
Their stated goal is complete eradication of the hybrid.
Oh my gosh.
Thoughts on that?
Mark Davis is a professor of biology at McAllister College. Back in 2011, he and some colleagues wrote a paper in Nature that questioned a lot of the dominant wisdom of conservation.
Namely, they took issue with the idea that native species are inherently better for an ecosystem than foreign or even invasive species.
And that an appropriate response, almost an obligatory response, is to try to eradicate the non-natives that have come in.
The way Mark sees it, ecosystems shift. Some species take over, some go extinct. Scientifically, there's no harm, there's just change. So unless a critter is ruining crops or spreading disease, the species we choose to preserve or protect, that reflects our human priorities, not some will of nature.
The term harm and damage, you know, that's always in the eye of the beholder. Once you declare something as harmful, you kind of oblige society then to step in and try to deal with the harm, which, you know, costs money and uses resources.
To be clear, Mark Davis is not saying we should definitely let Spartina take over. He's just saying that the decision to fight it isn't purely objective or scientific. It's more that we've decided that the way this habitat used to be is worth fighting for. And it's the idea that nature isn't a fixed thing. It's whatever we decide it is.
It really is trying to create a little ecological museum, which, you know, cannot be very big simply due to the practical measures of gardening nature, basically.
None of this is news to Toby or Jen. They're practical about their mission. They just think that the scales are tipped way in favor of fighting Spartina.
So hybrid Spartina might be good for one species that's endangered, the rail. So it would really end up being hybrid Spartina and Ridgeway's rails at the cost of hundreds of other species.
On our last stop, we see what the current standstill looks like. 46 acres of marsh, totally overrun with invasive Spartina and with rails.
Tell me how you feel when you look at this.
I have some frustration, for sure. This is pretty much what we'd call a monoculture of the invasive Spartina, but I like to call these rail farms because this isn't really good for anything else. This epitomizes the difficulty of the project. Right now, we're just not touching this.
Yeah.
We don't know what to do with this.
On our way back to the car, we stop by a big expanse of mudflat. This is what all those shorebirds desperately need, and it's what the hybrid grass is destroying. Toby peers through his binoculars, and sure enough, finds a little sprig of hybrid Spartina poking up through the mud. He makes a note to come back and kill it next month.
So this salt pond is eventually going to be turned back into marsh. They're going to break down one of the levees out there, and the bay is going to come rushing right back in. And this will probably all be covered in hybrid Spartina, unless Toby and Jen can figure that out.